Dear students, in previous video we have discussed first 23 chemistry questions in NEET 2020. In this video we will discuss the remaining 22 questions in NEET 2020. The question is elimination reaction of 2-bromopentane to form pent-2-enease. Okay, options: beta elimination reaction follows Sedgoff rule, dehydrohalogenation reaction and dehydration reaction. Okay, let us take a 2-bromopentane. Okay, this is a 2-bromopentane, CH3, CH2, CH2, CHBr and CH3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's a 2-bromopentane. Okay, this one is converted into pent-2-ene. This is a 5-carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. At second position, there is a double bond ene. Okay. In this reaction, there is an elimination of HBr. Okay, Br from second carbon and hydrogen from third carbon. Then only there is a formation of bond between, double bond between second carbon and third carbon. So, in this case, this is a 1-2 elimination. This one is, okay, elimination takes place at first position and second position. So, it's a 1-2 elimination. 1-2 elimination is also called as beta elimination. Know that 1-1 elimination is alpha, 1-2 elimination is beta, and 1-3 elimination is gamma, like that. So, here, the groups which are detached from the molecule or from first and second position, adjacent position, so it is called as beta elimination. So this one is correct and it follows Sedgoff rule. Here if you observe product, you are getting more substituted alkane, more substituted alkane. If you get more substituted alkane, the reaction follows Sedgoff rule. Suppose if you get this product, okay, this one is less substituted alkane. Okay, this one follows Hoffman. This is a Hoffman product. It follows a Hoffman rule. So here you are getting more substituted product, so it follows Sedgoff rule. This one also correct. Dehydrohalogenation reaction. Okay, dehydro. D means remove. Okay, removal of groups. Hydro, hydrogen and halogen. Here there is a removal of hydrogen and halogen, so it's a dehydrohalogenation reaction. Dehydration reaction. What is the meaning of dehydration? D means removal, hydration, hydra means water. If the water molecule is removed from the organic molecule, then it can be called as dehydration reaction. In this case, there is no removal of water molecule, so it's not a dehydration reaction. So what are the correct options? A, B, C. Okay, first one is the correct option. The mixture which shows positive deviation from the Raoult's law is. Here mixtures are given. We know that suppose if you take liquid A, liquid B. Okay, these are the two liquids. When you mix, you are mixing liquid A and liquid B, there is a formation of solution. There is a formation of solution. Okay, the solution is AB. What is the solution? AB solution. Suppose, what are the intermolecular attraction forces between? Intermolecular attraction forces, if you take. In liquid A, you can find intermolecular attraction forces between A and A molecule. Here B and B molecule. Here between A and B. Suppose the intermolecular attraction forces between A and A, B and B, okay, is equal to A and B, then there is no deviation. No deviation from Raoult's law. That one is called as a ideal solution, no deviation from Raoult's law. Suppose the attraction forces AA between AA and BB is greater than AB, means the attraction forces between A molecule and B molecule is less when compared with the A and BB, then the deviation is positive deviation. It means the solution has more vapor pressure than calculated value. Suppose if AA, the attraction forces between AA and BB is less than AB, means in solution you can find very strong attraction forces. It means the vapor pressure of the solution is very less. The escaping tendency of molecules is very less. So here you can find negative deviation. The vapor pressure is less. Negative deviation. Here you have to find out which one exhibits positive deviation. Positive deviation, if you take ethanol and acetol, between ethanol and ethanol you can find strong intermolecular attraction forces, and acetone and acetone you can find, but in between ethanol and acetone the attraction forces are weaker when compared with ethanol and acetone and acetone. So this one exhibits a positive deviation from Raoult's law. Suppose if you take benzene and toluene, both have similar structure, benzene and toluene, and the attraction forces between benzene and benzene, toluene and toluene is equal to benzene and toluene. So here there is no deviation. So no deviation here. Acetone and chloroform. If you take acetone, this is the structure, acetone. Okay. And chloroform, if you take, this is the chloroform. Okay. This is the chloroform. In between acetone and chloroform, there is a formation of hydrogen bond. This bond is the intermolecular forces between acetone and chloroform, hydrogen bond. It's very strong when compared with the dipolar-dipolar attraction forces between acetone and chloroform and chloroform. So in this case, there is a negative deviation from the Raoult's law. And chloroethane, bromoethane, ethane, here also ethane, both are halogens. Okay, nearly same structure and the same attraction forces between chloroethane and bromoethane and between chloroethane and bromoethane. So in this case there is no deviation. So which one is the correct option? The first one exhibits positive deviation from the Raoult's law, that is ethanol and acetone. Okay, this is the first, and this is the correct option. Which of the following is the correct order of increase in field strength of ligands to form coordination compounds? Here, okay, this is from coordination chemistry. In coordination chemistry, we have spectrochemical series. Spectrochemical series. In this series, we can find on the right side, you can find very strong field ligands such as COCN minus and NO2 minus PPH3 like that. In left side you can find very weak ligands such as halogens like that. Okay, in this case, which one is a strong field ligand? Obviously, CN minus is very strong field ligand. So this one is greater than. If you compare C2O4 2 minus F minus SCN minus, C2O4 2 minus is strong field ligand. Next one is F minus, and next one is SCN minus. So this is the order of strength of ligands. Suppose if you take NCS minus, suppose if it is given NCS minus, this one is stronger than even C2O4 2 minus. Okay, then what is the order? SCN minus, F minus, and C2O4 2 minus, and NCS minus, and CN minus. This is the order. But in this case we have SCN minus. So this one is weak field ligand when compared with F minus. So what is the answer? The first one is the answer. This is the correct order. Which of the following is a basic amino acid? Okay. Here amino acids are given: serine, alanine, tyrosine and lysine. Okay. In amino acids, we have neutral amino acids, basic amino acids and acidic amino acids. Okay. We have more number of neutral amino acids. It's very difficult to remember the names, but we have very few basic and acidic amino acids. Suppose if you take acidic basic LAH, okay, this one is L is lysine and A is arginine and this one is histidine. Okay, these three are basic amino acids. If you remember these three names, you can easily identify which one is the basic amino acid. And the acidic, you have two only. One is glutamic acid, and aspartic acid. Okay, if you remember these basic and acidic amino acids, you can easily find out which one is basic, which one is acidic, and which one remaining are all neutral. So you can easily identify which are neutral. So in this case, which one is the basic amino acid? Lysine is the basic amino acid. The remaining three are neutral amino acids. Okay. HCl was passed through a solution of CaCl2, MgCl2 and NaCl. Which of the following compounds crystallizes? Which of the following compound crystallizes? Okay. If you take some metal chloride, MgCl, and if you pass, okay, this one dissociates into Mn plus and NCl minus. Suppose if you pass HCl, means you are increasing concentration of Cl minus. Due to common ion effect, the equilibrium shifts towards this side and there is a formation of crystals of MgCl Ln. Okay, this is a solid. This one completely dissociates into Mn plus and NCl minus in aqueous phase. When you pass HCl gas through the solution, then there is a formation of crystals of MgCl Ln. Okay. Suppose if you take some hydrous salt, this one is anhydrous salt. If you take MgCl Ln, some XH2O, you can have some hydrated salts also. In this case, it is very difficult to form crystals. Okay, you have to identify which are anhydrous salts, which are hydrated salts. We know that NaCl, okay, here there is no water molecules, so NaCl can be easily crystallized by passing HCl gas. If you take MgCl2 or CaCl2, MgCl2 or CaCl2. Okay. If you take these two compounds, these are hydrated salts, 6H2O and 6H2O. So due to hydration of these salts, it is very difficult to crystallize these salts. So what is the correct option? Only NaCl can be crystallized. We can conclude that the salts which are anhydrous in nature, these can be crystallized by passing HCl. The salts which are hydrated salts, which cannot be crystallized by passing HCl. Which of the following is a natural polymer? This one is 1,4 polyisoprene. Isoprene units, you know, this is isoprene unit, 1,3 butadiene at second position, 2-methyl, 1,3 butadiene. This is the isoprene unit. Okay, if you take this 1,4 polyisoprene, this is the natural rubber. This is the natural rubber. Okay, in natural rubber, you have polyisoprene units, and also there is another natural polymer, gutta percha. Okay, there is a slight difference. In Ghatapracha, there is a trans 1,4-polyisoprene. In this case, what is the geometry? Trans geometry. In case of natural rubber, you can find this 1,4-polyisoprene. In case of Ghatapracha, this is also natural rubber, which is obtained from the plant bark. In this case, the trans 1,4-polyisoprene units you can find. Remaining all are synthetic. Synthetic. All these are lab made. These are not natural polymers. So what is the correct option? The first one is the correct option. Which of the following is not correct about carbon monoxide? Okay, it forms carboxy hemoglobin. Okay, this one is true. Okay, Hb and CO. Okay, this one CO combines with forms coordinate covalent bond with the iron in hemoglobin. So this one forms HbCO, and it reduces oxygen carrying ability of blood. Okay, when you compare the affinity of the affinity of attachment with hemoglobin, when compared CO and O2, the CO has more affinity to attach with hemoglobin. So suppose if you take HbO2, okay, in presence of CO, carbon monoxide, the oxygen molecules will be replaced. HbCO, CO plus O2. Here we know that CO is a strong field ligand, O2 is a weak field ligand. The strong field ligands can form very strong coordinate covalent bonds with the Hb, hemoglobin. That's why HbCO is more stable. This one is less stable. So the CO can replace oxygen in oxyhemoglobin. This one also correct. First one correct, second one correct. And the carboxyhemoglobin is less stable than oxyhemoglobin. This one is not correct. Carboxyhemoglobin is more stable when compared with oxyhemoglobin. Okay, not correct. You have to find out. It is produced due to incomplete combustion. Okay, we know upon incomplete combustion you will get CO, and complete combustion will give CO2. Okay, this one is, it is produced due to this one is true. So what is the correct option? Third one is the correct option. Sucrose on hydrolysis gives, okay, this one is very simple question. This one is alpha D glucose. In sucrose we have D glucose and D fructose, here beta D fructose. When you hydrolyze sucrose, you will get alpha D glucose and beta D fructose. Alpha D glucose and beta D fructose. Third one is the correct option. Suppose you can find other salts or other sugars also, disaccharides, lactose, if you take lactose and mannose. In lactose you have galactose and glucose. Galactose and glucose. In this case you can find beta D galactose and beta D glucose. In mannose you have both are glucose units, and this one also glucose units. And in this case you can find alpha D glucose and alpha D glucose. Both are alpha D glucoses. Okay, these are the very common disaccharides. Sucrose you can find alpha D glucose and beta D fructose. In lactose you have galactose and glucose. The form is beta D galactose and beta D glucose. In mannose both units are glucose and both the units are alpha D glucose. So what is the correct option? The correct option is third one. The following metal ion activates many enzymes, okay, participate in the oxidation of glucose to produce ATP, and with sodium it is responsible for the transmission of nerve signals. Okay, we know that potassium sodium channel, potassium sodium pumps are pumping. Okay, due to transfer of potassium and sodium through the membrane of cell, there is a formation of nerve signals. Okay, which one is the correct option? Potassium is the correct option. Which one of the following has maximum number of atoms? Maximum number of atoms means, okay, you have to indirectly maximum number of moles. Okay, if you multiply number of moles with Avogadro number, you will get number of atoms. Okay, if you calculate number of moles, you can easily identify which one has maximum number of moles. Suppose if you take 1 gram of AZ, weight by gram molecular weight 108 moles, 1 by 108 moles. This one is 1 by 24 moles, and 1 by 16 moles, and this one is 1 by 7 moles. So the compound which has less atomic mass, that one has more number of moles and more number of atoms. So this is the correct option. Which one of the following has maximum number of atoms? 1 gram of lithium. Okay, when the amounts are same, here in all the cases 1 gram, then amount is same, the compound which has less atomic mass, that compound has more number of atoms. The number of protons, neutrons and electrons, okay, 71 lutetium, 175 respectively odd. Okay, we can represent lutetium. This is a Z, this is the A. Here, what is a Z? Z is a number of protons, and this one is equal to number of electrons. Okay, this one is equal to 71. Okay, here protons, neutrons, electrons. This is the sequence, protons and electrons. Okay, and the number of neutrons, suppose this is A minus Z, atomic mass minus atomic number, 175 minus 71. What is the number? 104. Okay, this is the number of neutrons. Okay, first one is the correct option. Okay, very simple question. What is the change in oxidation number of carbon in the following reaction? Okay, you have to identify change in oxidation number of carbon. Okay, this is a carbon in reactant case, this is the carbon in product case. Okay, we know that the electronegativity of hydrogen is less than carbon. Suppose if you take CH4, what is the oxidation state of carbon? Okay, the molecule is zero. As the molecule zero, let us take X and 4 into, since the electronegativity of hydrogen is less, it gets plus 1 charge. So X is equal to minus 4. Suppose if you take CCl4, as a molecule, the charge is zero, X, the chlorine is more electronegative. The charge of chlorine will be minus 1. Here you have 4 chlorine, so 4 into minus 1. So finally X is equal to plus 4. What is the change? Minus 4 to plus 4 is the change. And third one is the correct option. Identify the incorrect statement. Okay. The first statement, Cr2+, okay, this one is D4 electronic configuration, is a stronger reducing agent than Fe2+. D6 in water. Okay, suppose if you take D4 configuration, okay, reducing agent means it should release electron, D3 plus electron. This is a change in electronic configuration. Okay, in case of Cr2+, this is a change. And if you take Fe2+, what is the change? D6 changes to D5 plus electron. So this is a Cr2+, this is the electronic configuration of Cr3+, and this is the configuration of Fe3+. Okay, here you have to compare the stability of Cr3+ and Fe3+, which one is more stable. Generally we think that D5 configuration is more stable. Okay, it is true in atomic state. In elemental form, it is true. D5 electronic configuration is more stable. But in case of complexes, you have to calculate crystal field stabilization energy. Suppose if you take D3 electronic configuration, here T2z set of orbitals and ez set of orbitals. Okay, here there is a formation of CrH2O6 3 plus complex here, Fe3H2O6 3 plus complex here. What is the ligand? Okay, weak field ligand D3. This is the D3 electronic configuration. What is the crystal field stabilization energy? CFSE. The crystal field stabilization energy is minus 0.4 × 3. So minus 1.2 delta naught. Okay, here there is a stabilization. Suppose if you take D5 electronic configuration. Okay, what is crystal field stabilization? This is electronic configuration 1, 2, 3. Since what is the weak field ligand? The arrangement will be like this. In this case, what is the crystal field stabilization energy? In this case, the crystal field stabilization energy is 0. This one is minus 1.2 delta naught. This one also plus 1.2 delta naught. So if you take the sum, the crystal field stabilization energy is 0. So which one is the stable? D3 is the stable. So the Cr2 plus can be easily converted into Cr3 plus. In this case, when you compare Cr2 plus to Cr3 plus conversion and Fe2 plus to Fe3 plus conversion, which one is very easy? This one is very easy. So this one is a stronger reducing agent. This one is correct. The transition metals and their compounds are known for their catalytic activity due to their ability to adapt multiple oxidation states and form complexes. That's why. Okay, this one is directly from NCERT. Transition metals. Why transition metals exhibit catalytic property? It is due to multiple oxidation states and due to formation of complexes. Interstitial compounds, we know that small atoms are trapped inside the crystal lattice of metals. This one also correct. The oxidation states of chromium in Cr0O4 2- and Cr2O7 2- are not the same. Actually, both are same. This one is also plus 6, this one also plus 6. You can calculate like this. If you take this one, what is the charge? Total charge minus 2 and x 4 × −2. So x is equal to minus 2 plus 8 is equal to 6 plus 6. In case of this one, total charge minus 2 and 2x 7 × −2. So 2x is equal to minus 2 plus 14 is equal to 12. So that implies x is equal to 6. In both the cases, what is the oxidation state? The oxidation state is plus 6. Okay, this one is wrong. So this is what is the incorrect statement? This is the incorrect statement. This is the answer. For the reaction, okay, here the atoms are converted into molecules. The correct option is, okay, when atoms are converted into molecules, okay, there is a release of energy. It's an exothermic reaction. So in exothermic reaction, delta RH is less than 0. And also in left side, you have 2 mole of gaseous molecules. Here right side, you have 1 mole. Okay, when the number of gaseous molecules decreases, the entropy decreases. So delta SR less than 0. So which one is the correct option? Third one is the, not third one, fourth one is the correct option. Exothermic and there is a decrease in entropy. Okay, as the number of gaseous molecules decreases, entropy decreases. So fourth one is the correct option. Measuring zeta potential is useful in determining which property of colloidal solution. It is also directly from NCERT. Zeta potential, this one measures the stability of the colloidal particles. Okay, as the zeta potential increases, this is the zeta potential, ZP increases, the stability of colloids increases directly proportionally. More the zeta potential, more the stability of colloids. Urea reacts with water to form A, which will decompose to form B. When passed through Cu2 plus deep blue color solution. Okay, deep blue color. actually blue color solution, deep blue color solution. C is formed. What is the formula of C from the following? Okay, you have to identify C. Okay, if you take urea, what is the formula? NH2, CO, NH2. Suppose when you react with water, okay, there is a hydrolysis, there is a release of ammonia plus and H4H, CO, NH2. And if you add another molecule, so this one, when you heat it, it will be decomposed into NH3 plus H2O. So finally, you will get ammonia. Okay. B, when passed through Cu2 plus aqueous solution. Okay, this is the B. When you pass it through Cu2 plus solution, there is a formation of complex CuNH3 4 times 2 plus. Due to this complex, the color is deep blue color. This is blue color, CuSO4 is blue color. This one is deep blue color. Okay, this one is the correct option. CuOH twice, CuCO3, CuOH twice. This one is malachite. This is in green color. Malachite, this is a ore of copper. Match the following and identify the correct option. CO plus H2, okay, this one is synthesis gas, okay, directly from NCRT. Temporary hardness of water due to bicarbonates, calcium and magnesium bicarbonates. B2H6, in B2H6 you can find three centered two electron bonds, okay, electron deficient bond is a, so an electron deficient hydride. H2O2 is a non-polar, non-planar structure. Okay, this is the structure, open book structure. Okay, this is non-planar, open book is a non-planar geometry. So which one is the correct option? A3 and B1 and C2 and D4. So first one is the correct option. Which one is the correct option? First one. Match the following. Okay, oxides are given. What is the nature of oxide? You have to find out. Generally, metal oxides in lower oxidation state, generally basic. Okay, when you dissolve metal oxides in water, it forms a basic solution. Okay, when you take non-metal oxide in higher oxidation state, will be acidic. Okay, when you dissolve non-metal oxides, there is a formation of acidic solution. Some neutral are also there. Very few are neutral. You can easily remember. Okay, H2O is a neutral oxide. And CO is a neutral oxide, nitrous oxide is a neutral oxide, and NO. These are the four neutral oxides. Okay, amphoteric means these can react with both acids, dual nature. Amphoteric means they react with both acids and also bases. They react with H plus and also OH minus. We have ZnO2 and Al2O3. All these are amphoteric. So what is this one? CO is neutral. BaO, barium oxide, it's a metal oxide, so basic. Al2O3 is amphoteric, and Cl2O7, chlorine, non-metal in higher oxidation state, obviously acidic. This is amphoteric and this is acidic. So you have to match this one. Okay, CO is neutral, BaO is basic, Al2O3 is amphoteric, Cl2O7 is acidic. So CO2, this one A is 2, B is 1, and C is 4, and D is 3. Okay, second option is the correct option in this question. The rate constant for the first order reaction is, rate constant is given, K is given, a first order reaction, 4.6 or 6 into 10 to the power of minus 3 second inverse. The time required to reduce 2 gram of the reactant to 0.2 gram is, okay, what is the time required? We know that T is equal to 2.303 by K log the initial concentration A by and A minus X. Here 2.303 by K, what is the K value? 4.606 into 10 to the power of minus 3 log. Here the time required to reduce 2 gram, okay, this is the initial 2 gram of the reactant 2, not by, suppose the time required to produce reduce 2 gram of the reactant by 0.2 gram means here X is 0.2. Okay, here reactant to reduce 2 gram of the reactant to 0.2 grams is A minus X is 0.2. This is the final concentration. This is the initial concentration. This is the final concentration. This one is initial. This one is the final concentration. So, what is the value you will get? T is equal to 2.303. Okay, here 2.303. Two times, so this one is 1 by 2 10 cube 10 to the power of minus 3, it will be 10 cube and log 2 by 0.2, it's a 10 log 10 1, so 10 cube by 2 1000 by 2, it will be 500 seconds. Okay, what is the answer? 500 seconds. An alkene on ozone analysis gives methanol as one of the product, aldehyde, methanol, simple methanol, this is a methanol. Okay, this type of fragments will give methanol. Okay. Some, suppose if you take the ozone analysis of this product, this is a CHO, SCHO or HC double bond. So you have to identify the molecule which has double bond CH2 fragment. In this case, there is no double bond CH2. Here, there is a double bond CH2. So, this one become methanol. And here, there is no, here also there is no double bond CH2. So, third one is the correct option. Which of the following alkene cannot made in good yield by Wood's reaction? Okay, in Wood's reaction, you can prepare symmetric even number of alkanes, even number of alkanes, okay, even number of carbons containing alkanes, okay, symmetric. Here n-hexane, it's a symmetric 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, it's a symmetric and also it's an even number, so it can be prepared. 2, 3 dimethyl butane, this is butane. 2,3-dimethyl, this one also symmetric, okay, this one also symmetric, suppose this fragment and this fragment, symmetric and even number of alkanes, it is also prepared. Heptane is a odd number, the carbons, number of carbons are odd, so this cannot be prepared, it can be prepared, but the yield is very low. For the preparation of N-heptane, you have to take two different alkyl halides. If you take two different alkyl halides, the yield of there is a formation of three compounds, so the yield of individual compound will be very less, so in this case you will get poor yield. Okay, this one cannot be prepared in good yield. N-butane, this is also symmetric and even number of carbons are there, it can be prepared in good yield. So, which one is the correct option? Which cannot be made in good yield means N-heptane. Third one is the correct option. Anisole on cleavage of cleavage with HA gives. Okay, anisole is given. This is the anisole. this is the NSO. Okay, when you react with HI, okay, this is the HI. This one dissociates into H plus and I minus. Acidic medium. In acidic medium, there is a protonation. First, there is a protonation. So this one becomes a so here there is a protonation. Let us take that this is a protonation and this one is positive charge. Here I minus, attack of I minus, it's a nucleophilic substitution reaction. Here in which carbon or in which on which I minus can attack? Here I minus can easily attack on this carbon and these electrons come towards right. Okay, this one is SN2 type of nucleophilic substitution reaction. So finally you will get OH and CH3I. So what is the product? You will get this one is the product OH plus CH3I.